the UNIMAP EduSolutions Private Limited cordially welcomes you to unlock your educational dreams.
Hi friends, myself Ahmed Sharif. This video is brought to you by UNIMAP EduSolutions Private Limited, head office Coimbatore, branch office Telangana, Hyderabad. Today I am here with our guest. She has been pursuing her master's in TU-Darmstadt and I would like to introduce her.
Hello friends, this is Priyanka Pathak. I am from Mumbai. I have completed my bachelor's from Mumbai University in electronics and telecommunication. After that, I have worked in Tata Consultancy Services for 2.5 years. And currently, I am doing my master's in TU-Darmstadt in Information and Communication Engineering. And now, as part of my course, I am doing an internship in National Instrument.
It has been interesting that I am first time meeting a person who has been pursuing her master's in TU-Darmstadt. Can you explain that work experience does really help in your master's?
As I have told you earlier, I worked in an IT firm like Tata Consultancy Services, and I mostly worked on testing part, which includes automation testing, which is mainly based on programming. Okay. So in TU-Darmstadt, I found that programming skills very useful. Moreover, in my during my internship as well, I'm finding it a bit easy to program because of my work experience. So yes, I found it very useful.
So your bachelor's is from like which specialization?
I have done my bachelor's in electronics and telecommunication.
So like how you choose the specific master's, like it's like combination of both?
Yes, I have done my bachelor's in electronics and telecom, and I am more inclined towards telecommunication. Okay. So I searched a course which mainly focuses on telecommunication, and currently I am doing my master's in information and communication, and there are many subjects which are related to telecom parts which attracted me more. So that's why I selected this course.
So as an overview, can you give how the course in these 2 years, like what are the subjects you are going to pursue?
Mm-hmm. There are 2-3 modules. In one module, there are 6 mandatory subjects which you have to do compulsorily.
Yeah.
And it consists of various domains like IC design, then optical communication, mobile communication, as well as machine learning. So there are different domains.
Okay.
That you have to do compulsorily. And other than that, there are optionals.
Okay.
Which you have to select on the basis of your interest. So in my case, I have selected subjects mainly which mainly focus on telecommunication.
So as you have completed 2 semesters, right? So
3 semesters.
So
yeah.
How do you feel the examination difference right over like in our home country and in Germany though?
In our home country, I would say we are following a specific pattern. But this is not the case over here. Here we have to understand the concept thoroughly because the examination pattern is not fixed. And to give an example, I would say you have 1.5 hours and you have to write a paper for 100 marks.
Okay.
So it's a complete test of how you understand the subjects, how you understand the concept, and
okay.
You can perform better only when you have understood it thoroughly.
Okay.
So you have to learn it in that way, and it, yeah.
So what would you suggest for particularly this course, like what are the initial brush-ups to be done back over in India for choosing this course?
Exactly. For this particular course, I would suggest you have to brush up a little bit of basics of the subjects we are mostly interested. In my case, I have done revision of GSM, LTE, at that topics which
okay.
Which I am more keen to pursue. So yeah, I would say you brush up the basics of the subjects you are opting for. So in my case, I have cleared the basic concepts of communication.
Okay.
For you as well, I would say if you are fixed with the subjects you are going to take, then brush up that basics.
Okay.
And one more thing, I would say learn German language little bit before coming over here. It will help you a lot in day-to-day life.
Okay. So regarding the internship, as now
mm-hmm.
you are pursuing the internship.
Yeah.
So how your application process was, like completely in English or you done in German?
Here in Germany, most of the application processes are online processes. So you just have to go to their portal. There, the whole description of the job will be present, and you have to just apply online.
Okay.
So most of the time, those forms will be in German, but you can easily translate it, and you can easily apply to those companies, and it would not be that difficult, at least for me, to apply to different companies.
Okay, like, can I know the like how many you have applied for?
For an internship, I have applied as many as I can.
Okay.
To give an example, I have applied almost 25 to 30 companies.
Okay.
And I have received interview calls from 3 to 4.
Okay.
But this specific position which I have selected, it mainly works on 5G NR, so which is of my interest. So
okay.
I selected this for an internship.
Okay, and like in the work atmosphere, or like your documentation regarding the work is done in German or in English?
Regarding work, it was in German. The whole contract was in German. So
okay.
For me, I have to translate it little bit, and
okay.
I have to go through it. That's why I suggested knowing German is a very good benefit over here.
Like submitting your reports regarding your work is in English or in German?
No, regarding my work, it's overall in English only.
Okay. So, now you know the importance of language as a student, and now in the internship.
Mm.
Internship doesn't matter, differ with job, I feel. So it's an extended thing for the job.
Yeah.
And can I know the life in Darmstadt, like what is the accommodation expense or
In Darmstadt, mostly students opt for a student and work apartment, but as we all know, like the number of students are more and the apartments are less. So initially we have to look for other apartments other than student and work. So I would say the rent is around 290 on an average, and apart from that you have to pay compulsory health insurance. So, and other than that, the cost of living is totally depends on the person to person.
Yeah, so almost we can say without food it is around 360 euro.
Exactly.
And how do you feel like life in Darmstadt? Like you have been staying there, right?
Yeah, it's quite cool. If you are staying in student and work, then you'll come to know students of different culture completely, and you can share your experiences with
yeah.
them. So it will be a good experience actually.
Okay, and what would be your suggestion for the upcoming freshers, like who look towards Germany?
Yeah, I would suggest them, like by thinking to come to Germany is a very good option. You can definitely go for it. But before coming over here, I would tell them, like, brush up your basics for the subjects. And one more thing, German, about German language, like learn German language as much as you can. It will definitely help you surviving over here.
Thanks for your valuable time, and it has been great talking to you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You can register with us through our portal. So join us and be at the pinnacle of education through the best service provider. We keep your data protected, and we are determined to connect the world to Germany with our amicable assistance. For further details, visit us at www.unimap.in.